The following is a class on the Bhagavad Gita as it is. Second chapter, text number 13, given by His Divine Grace, A.C. Bhaktivedanta Swami Prabhupada, recorded on the 18th of June, 1974, in Germany.
Vihina. Vihina means the one who possesses this body. That means the Vihina. It's like in Sanskrit word, gunino. Gunino means one who has got some special attribute. He is understanding more than any other. Yes. So, atmin deh. Now, that will create disturbance. Yeah. So one prophet, one law. You get a child and another child you cannot eat. This is karmakandya. This is the material world. As soon as you get some profit here, another child lost. As soon as you want to construct a big skyscraper, the another side digging her. Otherwise, where you get? You cannot create. These stones and bricks you cannot create. You have to dig from somewhere else and pile here. And that is advancement of civilization. To be engaged in digging and piling. This is called advancement of civilization. The rascals do not think, why uselessly I am digging and piling? After all, Maya will kick me out and there will no more digging and piling. But they are very much busy. They cannot come to hear Bhagavad Gita. They are very busy. This is called Maya. So, Dehina. Dehina means the possessor of the body. This simple thing that there is a proprietor of this body or possessor, actually you are not proprietor. We are occupier, just like a rented house. The proprietor is different man. Everyone is knows that if you rent a house, the proprietor is different man and the tenant is the occupier. That much. No proprietorship. So I am the spirit soul, I am not a proprietor, I am simply occupier. The rascal materialists, they do not know that the proprietor is the Supreme Personality of Godhead and He is giving me a particular apartment according to my capacity of paying rent. This is my belief. Otherwise, why everyone does not get first class body, king's body, or rich man's body? A child born immediately is rich man. So there is no arrangement. And another child born in the same moment is very poor man. Why? This is called karma kanda. This child is given a room, an apartment, according to his capacity of paying rent. The other child is given another apartment, very luxurious apartment, according to his capacity of rent paying. This is called karma kanda. According to your karma or work, you get a body, either as a king's son, or a cobbler's son, or a dog's son, or a cat's son, or a tree's son, or a plant's son. This is it. This is to understand. Krishna said in the last verse that the don't think we did not exist in the past, we are existing at present, and we shall continue to exist in the future. Exactly like that. That we live in one apartment, then if I am able to pay more rent, I transfer to another apartment, or if I cannot pay the present rent, then I'll have to move to another less rented apartment. This is called, I existed in one apartment, now I'm existing in one apartment, and I shall exist in another apartment. So I am eternal. I am simply changing my apartment address. This simple thing. Ashmin dehe jatha as Kumar Jobanam jara. In this life I am experiencing that I changed so many apartments. I was a child, that apartment I changed into boyhood. Then again I changed that apartment into youthhood. Then I am old man. So when this apartment will be vacated, I will have to accept another apartment. Where is the difficulty to understand? I must possess one apartment or body. The body is the apartment. Jasnasu buddhi kunapi siddhatu. It is just like this apartment, this room is made of brick, stone and cement. Similarly, this apartment is also made of this stone, brick or cement. So what is this body? This body and this material, huge, gigantic, what is the difference? No difference. Just like here in the material, in your presence you see so many rocks. See, the bones are like rock. And so many secretions within the abdomen. At least we know there is urine, there is water, just like there are sea water, ocean water. Similarly, if you examine continuously, the same thing as the whole material manifestation is made of, this body is also made of. There is no difference. Simply small quantity and big quantity. The ant's body is also made of the same ingredient. The elephant's body is also made of the same ingredient. And this gigantic universe, and so many planets, sun, moon and sky, that is also made of the same ingredient. It is only depends on big apartment and small apartment, that's all. But the proprietor or the occupier of the apartment is different. That is even. He is changing apartment. So that is also explained here. Deen asmin jathadi komarajo vanangara. This komarajo vanangara, we say, this is child's body. This is boy's body. So they are different apartments. And according to the apartment, one's intelligence or consciousness is developed according to the body. When the living being or the soul gets there, then you see a poor man living in a poor cottage or very unclean apartment, his mental is different. Another very respectable gentleman, he is living in a very nice house, nice apartment, his mental is different. So according to the circumstances, the mental changes are there. But the poor man is also human being and the rich man is also human being. Similarly, these so many apartments of different types of body, 8,400,000 different types of body, the occupier, the living being or the soul is the same quality. But according to the apartment or body has occupied, he has developed different consciousness and mental. Is it clear or not? Where is the difficulty? These rascals do not believe in the transmigration of the soul. But where is the difficulty to understand transmigration of the soul? That is very clearly stated. And who is stating? Krishna, the supreme authority. You cannot say, I don't believe in the transmigration. You may believe or not believe, but this is a fact. This is a fact. What you are, you don't believe, so what is lost or gained? Even if you believe or not believe. Nature's work will go on. You rascal, you believe or not believe. It does matter. Nature's work will go on. If you have done nicely to occupy first class apartment, then nature will give you a nice body. Therefore, I say repeatedly, I am saying again, that you Western people, Western boys, Western girls, all Western people, you are given very good chance by nature. Therefore, once upon a time, the whole European people were dominating all over the world because they are very intelligent. So they have got good intelligence, good resources, good nice body, beautiful body, everything is very good. But don't spoil it, utilize it for understanding further good. Don't spoil it simply behaving like cats and dogs. That is our Krishna consciousness movement. Krishna consciousness movement means that you are misled, simply bodily conscious of life. German is fighting, Englishman is fighting, France is fighting. Why is he fighting? If you know that I am not this body, I am spirit soul, why I am falsely identifying myself with the land? I am German because I am born in this land of Germany. That is also false. No land is Germany or France or England. Land is land. You have falsely named it. This is Germany. What is Germany? Say 200 years or 300 years, there is no Germany. That's America. There is no America. The land was there, but the name was not there. Say you have some Europeans, they have colonized there, say it is America. So this is all designation. Actual, the fact is, the land belongs not to you, not to the German, not to the Englishman, not to the American, but it belongs to God. The land was created by God. So it is God's property. Where is the difficulty to understand? You did not create anything. You did not create even your own body. That proprietor is also Krishna. Because as soon as Krishna asks you, please vacate, you must vacate immediately. Can you remain in this body? The proprietor asks you to vacate some or other. You have to vacate. Or the proprietor does not repair it, then he voluntarily vacates. So this is not to be no more useful. This is all going on. And that is how nicely it is explained. Dehinasmin jathade kumaram jovanandara. Tatha dehantara prati. As we have changed so many different types of bodies in this division of life, now how this change is taking place, that you cannot imagine, therefore we say the same body. But actually this is not the same body. The body is different. It is changing. And because the person, the soul is there, therefore it is changing. And as soon as the person is not there, suppose in a child's body, a born baby, a dead body, it will not grow or it will not change. So long the soul is there, it will change. So Krishna said that we existed in the past. This is authoritative statement. So it is to be understood that I existed in the past in different body. As I existed, say, 70 years before in a different body, I was jumping as a boy. Now I cannot jump, now I have to take this stage. But this is a different body. So what is the difficulty to understand? In the same body, anyway, then I could jump like a boy. I remember that I jumped, but now it is not possible. I have to take help of three men. So it is a different body. Although imperceptibly it has changed. But the body is different. Body is different. So in this way, if we try to understand, Vira Satya Namayati, Vira, those who are intelligent, sober, they are called Vira, not disturbed mind, not rascal. Rascals cannot understand. Therefore, the very word is used, Vira. What is the meaning, dhira? Dhira, the sober. Those who have got brain substance, not cow dung. Okay? They can understand. Therefore, one has to become intelligent. Dhira. For spiritual understanding, we have to create the favorable circumstances. Favorable circumstances, that's like to create healthy body. You have to remain in such a way that you will not fall sick. Similarly, dhira means, if you try to remain just like cats and dogs, then you remain as a cat or dog. But if you want to remain as a human being, then you must remain as perfect human being. Therefore, no illicit sex. Cats and dogs, they can have illicit sex. And if the human being also have the same process, then what is the difference between cats and dogs? Therefore, you have to be cautious, not to become cats and dogs, but to remain as human beings. Then you will be zero, sober, not agitated. Therefore, this very word is used. It is not understood by the cats and dogs. If I say to the cats and dogs that you are not this body, you are simply possessing this body, it is useless, because he has got a certain body that he cannot understand even in sustaining for 1,000 years. Because he has got a different body, cats and dogs body. But in the human form of body, there is possible. That is the difference between cats and dogs body and human body. So, to become zero means not to use the very important, very useful body, human body, to pass as cats and dogs. That is very dangerous. It's a great loss. Prahlad Maharaj instructed this, durlabham manasam janma. We have to be very intelligent to understand that I have got this body, must be after many, many births, that is the evolutionary theory, I can understand that this tree, that is also living being, but it is standing there for thousands of years. Thousands of years they are standing. So many Napoleon, so many Kaiser, so many Hitler came and gone, but the tree is standing. There is a punishment, but that is also a living being. It is also growing. As your body is growing or changing, that body is also growing and changing. Unless you pour water on the root of the tree, no eating, then it will die. Similarly, if you don't eat, you will die. You will die. There is no difference. It is simply different methods of living. That's all. The cats and dogs living in a certain method. The human being is living in a certain method. The trees are living in a certain method. The fish in the water, they are living in a certain method. But the eating, sleeping, mating, defending is there. So according to the different bodies, they are living differently. So all living entities, as Krishna said, that they existed. So existed in a different body, now existing in a different body, this is called evolution or transmigration. This is the evolution. Evolution theory is there, not theory, fact. Padma Purana. It is not Darwin's invention. Asiti Satunanga Saiva Jiva Jatis. I clearly stated the evolution fact. Is there are 8,400,000 different species of life and the living entity passing, transmigrating from one another. Therefore, when one comes to this human form of body, Prahlad Maharaj says, durlabham manasam janma. It is very rare, this human form of body. Why it is so rare? Na arthadam, adurvam. We shall die also. He shall give up this body, like the cats and dogs. But I can get a sublime knowledge in this body, the cats and dogs cannot get. Therefore, we should equalize this. So, to understand this importance of this body, is explained here that I am not this body. I am a spirit soul. I have been given a type of body by the material nature, under the order of Krishna and God. Prakriti kriyamanani gnai karmani sarvasa. These things are going on by the nature's law. The law is so perfect, just like I have given several times, that if you infect some disease, the nature's law is so perfect that you must suffer from that disease, unless you take precautions. Everyone knows that any infectious disease, because it is full of cheating, full of mistakes, full of illusion, imperfectness, then how we can understand the thing or the person is beyond your perception. That is not possible. Asinta kaluthi bhava natastakena jujaya. This is Vedic instruction. The things which are beyond our perception, don't try to understand by this foolish argument and logic. Don't try to understand. Achinta khaluje bhava. Achinta means beyond your conception. Chinta means within your perception. And achinta means beyond your conception. Achinta khaluje bhava. Natastakena. You cannot understand by this rascal logic and philosophy. That is not possible. Then how it is to be understood? There are many places. Ata Sri Krishna Namadi Navavit Rayam Indriyat. These blunt senses, you cannot understand Krishna, Krishna's name, Krishna's form, Krishna's qualities, Krishna's activities, you cannot understand. Then I have got this is my imposition. How can I understand Krishna? That is said, the Sevan Mukhi Jivhajo. When you engage your tongue in the service of the Lord. Now this is also another peculiar thing. The two understand by the tongue, not by the mind. Tongue. Tongue means we have got two businesses we perform with the tongue. One is tasting foodstuff and vibrating voice. We use the tongue, vibrating Hare Krishna Mahamantra and eat Krishna Prasada. But then you understand Krishna. You don't understand, but he reveals. And actually, that is happening. All over the world, these young boys and girls, because they are chanting Hare Krishna mantra, and because they are eating Krishna prasadam, now they are developing their Krishna consciousness. They are not Vedanti. They have not studied all the Vedas, but how they are understanding? If they are not understanding Krishna, how they are sticking to this life. In this life, everything is forbidden. No illicit sex, no gambling, no intoxication, everything, no. Material life, finish. Why they are sticking? Unless they are understanding Krishna. This is the proof. The more you stick to this principle, Sevan Mukhi Jivhajo, engage your tongue in true business, chanting Hare Krishna, and eat Krishna Prasad, your life will be perfect. Thank you very much. Yeah.